Can you actually believe it? Huawei. Yes, Huawei. Possibly make the best ultrabook and best phone you can buy right now. Alright champs, let's get rid of Windows Home and let's get some Windows Pro. Copy and paste my code from the description. New codes, new discount. You can get Windows Professional, Office. Paste my code. Boom. It's Windows Pro time. Yeah, I didn't expect that a couple of years ago. And you know, Huawei were on the radar, but I never thought for a second they would be making possibly the best phone and laptop on the market. Depending on your point of view, they have to be definitely up there. Now I'm going to talk about the Mate X Pro here, and I'll give you some reasons why I think this is the best ultrabook you can buy. And I guess I'm taking this from the perspective of someone that, you know, can only have one laptop. So let's talk about the things that separate this from the competition. First of all, price. $1,500 US for the top spec. I think £1,300, and in Australia was like $2,300. They're still sold out, by the way, in Australia. Cannot get them. Oh, come on, Huawei. Get them out there. But that just shows you how popular they really are. But for that sort of money, $1,500 US, go spec up another ultrabook to have 16 gigs RAM, 512 SSD. A lot of them you can't even get a graphics card. This one comes with an MX150 and spec them up with the premium display as well. Yeah, they're not going to be $1,500. So you get a fully loaded PC for $1,500 US. And this is a premium product here, you know, built as good as a MacBook Pro. Or any other ultrabook for that matter, the build quality is superb as well. So great price point, great build quality. It does everything right. Every single thing is done well. So it has good sound, good keyboard, good trackpad, good display. I'll get to the display later. So it's almost perfection in that, because perfection is just lots of little things done well. And this does everything well. So it's near on perfection there. Now I've already done a review on this and a gaming review. Check those out, and actually a content creation review as well. So check those three videos out. I'll link them in here. So I don't have to go through the specs that much, but it does have what an ultrabook will have. It has the 8th generation quad core 15 watt Kaby Lake R parts. So these are super powerful CPUs, and it also has an MX150 graphics. Now a lot of ultrabooks do not have graphics at all. They just have the built-in Intel graphics. They don't have discrete graphics. There are a few like the Razer Blade Stealth, and I just reviewed the ASUS ZenBook 14 that also has an MX150. So it's not the only one to have it, but you know, you can count on one hand how many ultrabooks do have it. And it's a big difference in video editing and gaming. Like if you want to do those sort of things, you cannot do it on an ultrabook on this. You can do 4K editing, you can do gaming. Yeah, all right, lower settings, but still you can get it done with this, which I wouldn't even try on an ultrabook without graphics. But there's one thing that separates this from those other ones that do have graphics, or even pretty much any other ultrabook, and that's the display. Oh my god, it is friggin' gorgeous. 3x2. It makes such a huge difference to have a 3x2 display on a 14-inch laptop. Much more real estate, vertical real estate. It's one of the best displays you're going to see on an ultrabook as well. Touch display, very bright, great color, great contrast. You can do color work on it. And there's no other ultrabook that really does have this sort of display with that 3x2. And give me this display any day. Let's just pretend everything else was the same on these other laptops, but this was the only difference. This is why I would get it. This display, the 3x2. Now, the only other ultrabook that I know that has a 3x2 display is the Surface Laptop 2. But that's missing Thunderbolt 3. And it doesn't have graphics either. Now, I actually reviewed the i7 Space Gray model, and actually Huawei sent me an i5 Silver model, which actually had 16 gigs RAM and MX150 in it too, because you can actually get it without the MX150. Don't do that. Make sure you do get the one with the graphics. But when it comes to i5, i7, if you can actually get the i5 with the MX150 and 16 gigs RAM, get that one, especially if it's cheaper, obviously. Because i5, i7, it's only clock speeds, and really it's not going to make much difference at all. But it's really hard to actually get the 16 gig and MX150 with the i5. I haven't actually seen that configuration myself. So they sent me that one. I don't know where you can buy that one. Usually you have to get the i7 to get the 16 gigs and MX150. So anyway, that's why I think it's probably the best ultrabook out there. The display, build quality, the extra oomph you get from graphics. It's just all around just a killer package that does everything right. and there's not really a con. I mean, it's almost perfect. So anyway, I just thought I'd put this video out there. I'd like to thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you think in the comments. Which Ultrabook would you buy? Would you buy this one? And until next time, guys, tally ho.